functions, right? What is meant by composition of functions? If we have a function f which is mapped from a to b, a and b are two sets, a function mapping is given from set a to b, f is given, and a mapping g is given from set b to set c. F is a mapping from a to b, g is a mapping from b to c. Then the composition of f and g denoted by g small o f. Okay, g then small o then f, g of f. We say it g o means of f. Then composition of f and g denoted by g of f is defined as g of f as a mapping from a to c. We have a mapping from a to b, then from b to c, then g of f composition will be a mapping which directly map from a to c, given by g of f of x is equals to, and it is g of f of x is equals to g in the bracket f of x. First we will solve the function f of x. Whatever the answer will be, then we will be solving the function g of x, and x will be from the first set A, like this set A. So this is composition of two functions. Now what type of questions related to this composition are? Let f be a mapping from a set 2 3 4 5 to 3 4 5 9, and g be a mapping from set 3, 4, 5, 9 to 7, 11, 15. And the functions be defined as f of 2 is equals to 3, f of 3 is equals to 4, f of 4 is equals to f of 5 is equals to 6. G of 3 is equals to g of 4 is equals to 7, and g of 5 is equals to g of 9 is 11. Find g of f. G of f means you have to find composition g of f of x. X we said is the first set of f, right? That means we will be taking x as every element 2 3 4 5. So first we will be finding g of f of 2, which means g of f of 2. F of 2 we will fill the value. F of 2 is given to us, it is 3. F of 2 is 3, it is given. So we will put the value g in the bracket, f of 2 is 3. Now again g of 3 is given to us, it is 7. So we will put the value 7. So this implies g of f of 2 is 7. Composition g of f of 2 is directly we are getting 7. Then next composition g of f of next element from the first set is 3. We will find for every element, which will be g in the bracket f of 3. Now f of 3 is given to us, it is 4. F of 3 is given to us, 4. So we will put the value g in the bracket 4. And g of 4 is given to us, it is 7. So we will put the value 7. So which implies composition of g of f of 3 is also 7. Right, then we will be finding next, for next element, g of f of 4. It is g in the bracket f of 4. It is g. What is f of 4? F of 4 again we will see. F 4 is given to us 5. So we will put the value g of 5. And G of 5 is what? G of 5 is given to us. It is 11. So we will put the value 11. So which implies if I am taking composition G of F of 4, it is 11. Right? So next we will find the composition for G of F of next element 5. G of F of 5, which is G in the bracket F of 5, which is equals to G. Now, F of 5 is what? F of 5 is equals to 5. So we will put the value 5 here. And G of 5 is what? G of 5 is already given to us 11. So we will put the value G of 5 is equals to 11. So this implies composition of F of 5 is 11. Right? So we are finding G of F of 2 is 7. G of F of 3 is 7. G of F of 4 is 11 and G of F of 5 is 11. G of F of X is given by G in the bracket F of X. And it is a composition from set A to set C. If this is a set A, this is a set B, this is set B and this is set C, then G of F of X is a composition from A to C. This is the way we find composition of two functions. The same way we can also find F of G of X, which will be equal to F in the bracket G of X. If in the question it will be asked, okay, it will be according to the question what F and G are given to us. So we are given two mappings and we have to find the composition. F is a mapping from 2, 3, 4, 5 to 3, 4, 5, 9. G is a mapping from 3, 4, 5, 9 to 7, 11, 15. And F of 2 is given, F of 3 is given, F of 4, F of 5. Every mapping is given to you. Similarly, G of 3, G of 4, G of 5, G of 9, it is given to you. You have to find G of F. G of F of X means G in the bracket F of X and you will simplify. So the very first we are finding G of F of 2. We will be taking X from the first set, right? So first mapping, that is A in general, which we take. So we will take all the elements one by one. The elements are 2, 3, 4, 5. First we are taking 2. G of F of 2 is equals to G in the bracket F of 2. F of 2 is mapped to 3. So we are writing the value of F of 2. So G in the bracket 3. Now G of 3 is given to you 7. So that means the composition G of F of first element 2 is 7. Then G of F of 3, next element 3, is equal to G in the bracket F of 3. F of 3, it is given to you 4. So G of 4 will be 7, right? So composition G of F for the second element 3 is 7. Now G of F of 4, right? The next element after 3 is 4. So it will be G in the bracket F of 4. The value of F of 4 is given to you 5. So G of 5 is given to you 11. So composition G of F for the third element 4 is 11. Then G of F of next element 5 is equal to G in the bracket F of 5. The value of F of 5 is given to you. It is 5. So G of, we will be having G of 5. The value of G of 5 is given to you 11. So the composition G of F5 is 11. Right? Any doubt in this composition, you can ask me. Otherwise, we will move to next example. Okay. Now the question is, find G of F and F of G. If the mapping from F is a mapping from all reals to reals and G is a mapping from all real to reals and is given by F of X is cos of X and G of X is 3X square. Find G of F, then F of G and then compare. You will find that the two compositions are not equal, right? So first we will be finding g of f of x. It will be g in the bracket f of x. It will be g. What is f of x? Put the value g in the bracket cos x. Now the next step is very important. How to find this g of cos x? In the previous examples, we were given the direction.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, please explain the very first step once.
Okay, fine. We have to, okay, the question is find g of f and f of g. If f is a mapping from set of all reals to set of all reals from R to R, and g is also a mapping from R to R, and we have given f of x is a mapping which mapped all x to cos x, and g of x is a mapping which map all x to 3x square. F of x is cos x, g of x is 3x square. We have to find g of f, f of g, then we will be comparing and we will be finding that the two values are not equal. We have to show that g of f is not equal to f of g. So first we are finding g of f. We are writing g of f of x, and as per the formula, it will be g in the bracket f of x. G of f of x is given to us. It will be g in the bracket f of x. So we are writing g in the bracket f of x. Now g as it is, put the value. F of x is given to you, cos x. I have substituted the value of f of x, which is cos x. Now how to write this g is very, very important. Okay. Now see, g of x is equals to 3x square, right? When I am having in the bracket x, then I am having 3x square. Now replace x by cos x. Okay, now replace x by cos x. This step is very important. So when you will replace x by cos x, what you will be getting? G x ki jagah cos x in the bracket. Okay, sorry. So g of cos x is equals to 3, and in place of cos x I will be having cos x square is equals to 3 cos square x. This you will be getting, right? So g of f of x is equals to g of f of x, which is g of cos of x. Now g of x is given to us 3x square. So how you will be finding g of cos x? In the x, you replace x by cos x. So g in the bracket cos x will be equal to 3 cos x square, which will be equal to cos square x. Therefore g of f of x will be equal to 3 cos square x. This will be the composition g of f of x. This is very important. Is this clear? Then we will be moving to next composition, f of g. How we are finding g of cos of x? G of x, I know it is 3x square. You have to replace x by cos x. So g in the bracket cos x will be 3. X is replaced by cos x square, which can be written as 3 cos square x. So g of f of x is 3 cos square x. Now I will be finding f of g. F of g of x is f in the bracket g of x. I have written the formula only. F of g of x is equals to f in the bracket g of x. In the next step, I will put the value g of x. G of x is 3x square, right? Now the next step is again very important. How to solve further? Okay. So we are given f of x is equals to cos x. To, but I want in the bracket 3x square. I know when f in the bracket x is there, my answer is cos x. For getting f in the bracket 3x square, I will replace x by 3x square. Wherever x is there in the function, I'll be replacing that with 3x square so that f in the bracket 3x square will be equal to cos in the bracket 3x square. X is replaced by 3x square. Cos in the bracket 3x square. So my composition will be is equals to which implies f of g of x is equals to f in the bracket 3x square will be equal to cos in the bracket 3x square. Clearly, f of this 3 cos square x is not equal to cos of 3x square, right? So clearly 3 cos square x is not equal to cos in the bracket 3x square. Therefore, f of we have to write g of f. We have 3 cos square x is not equal to cos in the bracket 3x square. Therefore, we will write g of f of x is not equal to f of g of x. This we have to prove. That first find g of f, then find f of g. When the mappings are f of x is cos x and g of x is 3x square. And we have to show that g of f is not equal to f of g. So first we will be finding g of f. We apply the formula g in the bracket f of x is equals to g. Put the value of f of x which is cos x. Now we will be finding what is g of cos x. We are given gx is equals to 3x square. But what we want in place of x, we want cos x. So we will replace x by cos x. Replacing cos by x by cos x, we will be getting g in the bracket cos x is equals to 3 as it is. And instead of x square x, we will be getting cos x square, which will be equal to 3 cos square x. So g of f of x is 3 cos square x. Now we will be finding f of g of x is f in the bracket g of x is equals to f. Put the value of g of x which is given to us 3x square. Now we have to find f of 3x square. F of x is cos x, but in place of x we want 3x square. So we will replace x by 3x square in the function f. So we will be getting f in the bracket 3x square is equals to cos as it is. X is replaced by 3x square. So f of g of x will be cos in the bracket 3x square. Clearly, 3 cos square x is not equal to cos of 3x square. Therefore, the composition g of f of x is not equal to the composition f of g of x. This you have to prove. Right? So the solution is also given in the book. You can read through that there also. But how to find the composition is very, very important. So the two examples are clear. Then we will move to the next. Next is show that if F is a mapping from R minus this 7 by 5 to R minus this 3 by 5. Why it is written? F is a mapping. F is a mapping from set of all reals minus 7 by 5. Why it is written minus 7 by 5? Because you can see the function f of x is 3x plus 4 upon 5x minus 7. So x, the denominator should not be 0, right? Therefore, we have written that x should not be equal to 7 by 5. So the domain is given, f is a mapping from all reals minus 7 by 5. Same way the domain is given for the range as well, all reals except to 3 by 5. So that the denominator don't become zero, right? But we have nothing to do with. We are only given the domain and range, and our main concern is with function only. What is the function? And we have to find the mapping, right? So we are given that the f is a mapping defined by f of x is equals to 3x plus 4 upon 5x minus 7. And g is a mapping, g of x is equal to 7x plus 4 upon 5x minus 3. Then we have to find f of g, and it will be identity. And we have to find mapping g of f, and it will be again be a identity, where a will be the domain set of all reals minus 3 by 5, and b will be the domain set of all reals minus 7 by 5. And IA is equals to X. Okay. So the answer should be equal to X. F of G will be IA, which means we should have X. And IB, which means we should have X, are called identity functions on set A and B. So what we have to do, we have to find the composition f of g, and the output should be x. We have to find the composition g of f, and the output will be x. When we will be finding the output x, that type of functions are called identity functions on set A and B. So we will start with f of g. Of x, we have nothing to do, we have to find the composition. Our concern is only finding the composition, and the output should be x. F of g of x will be f in the bracket g of x, f in the bracket g of x is a term, 7x plus 4 upon 5x minus 3. Now, how to solve this function is very, very important. F of 7x plus 4 upon 5x minus 3, I have substituted the value of g of x. I have to find this function. I know f of x is 3x plus 4 upon 5x minus 7. If I want in the bracket 7x plus 4 upon 5x minus 3, what I'll do? I will replace x with the 7x plus 4 upon 5x minus 3. So in the next step, my mapping on f will be 3 in the bracket. X I'm replacing with 7x plus 4 upon 5x minus 3. Plus 4 upon 5 in the bracket 7x plus 4 upon 5x minus 3 minus 7. This step is very, very important, that how we are writing. So is this clear? Why I am writing f of 7x plus 4 upon 5x minus 3 like this? My mapping is f of x is equals to 3x plus 4 upon 5x minus 7. And I have to replace x with the complete factor 7x plus 4 upon 5x minus 3. Because if I will be comparing f and x is replaced by 7x plus 4 upon 5x minus 3. That means f in the bracket, this whole term will be equal to 3. X ki jagah pe 7x plus 4 upon 5x minus 3 plus 4 as it is. 5. X ki jagah pe 7x plus 4 upon 5x minus 3 minus 7. Now the next step is do the calculations and solve. First, in the numerator, 5x minus 3 will be the LCM. So 3 into 7x plus 4 plus 4 into 5x minus 3 upon 5x minus 3 LCM, 5 into 7x plus 4 minus 7 into 5x minus 3. This you know that this the denominator this term is denominator ka denominator, and it becomes numerator, or you can say you can cancel this 5x minus 3 with 5x minus 3. So you will be having the terms left with you. Three into 7x plus 4 is equals to 3 into 7x plus 4 plus 4 into 5x minus 3 upon 5 into 7x plus 4 5 into 7x plus 4 minus 7 into 5x minus 3. We have to solve the calculations and our output should be x. 7 threes are 21 into x plus 4 threes are 12 plus 5 fours are 20x minus 4 threes are 12 upon 7 5s are 35x plus 5 4s are 20 minus 7 5s are 35x minus 7 3s are 21. So 12 12 cancel each other. 21 plus 20 is equals to 41x. 35, 35 cancel each other, and minus minus it will be plus here. 20 plus 21, 41. So 41 and 41 cancel each other. Our output is x. This implies g of f of x is equals to x, which is equals to identity a, which was given to us, that ia of x is equals to x, and we have to g of f of g we have calculated now, so I've written it wrong. It will be f of g of x is equals to I of a, right? So this is very important, that how to put the values in composition. After that, you have to do simple calculations. You are given two mappings, f of x and g of x. You have to find f of g. You have to find g of f. F of g should be I of a, which is given to you that I of a is equals to x. That means f of g should be equal to x, and g of f should be equal to x. And these IA and IB are called identity functions on set A and set B, right? So the solution is also given to you in your book. We have calculated this f of g of x, which means f of, we have substituted the value of g of x, then we have applied it as per the function, and we are getting 41x upon x. 41 is equals to x. Same way we can find g of f. G of f will be g in the bracket f of x f of x, the value we are substituting 3x plus 4 upon this 3x plus 4 upon 5x minus 7. This is the value of f of x. Now we have to apply the composition. We know that g of x is 7x plus 4 upon 5x minus 3. So we will apply the composition. Wherever x is, we will replace this x with 3x plus 4 upon 5x minus 7. So g in the bracket 3x plus 4 upon 5x minus 7 plus 4 and 5 in the bracket 3x plus 4 upon 5x minus 7 minus 3. One step is escaped here. The direct calculations are given, but you will be doing one step taking LCM. Okay, you will take the LCM, you will multiply the terms and you will be finding that output is again x. That means g of f is also x and f of g is also x, which implies that g of f is I of b and f of g is I of a. Right? This way you will prove. Now questions you can practice and we will be doing more examples tomorrow because the time is short. Okay? Or 6 minutes. Okay, we will discuss one more question.
Is this function of plus 1 or plus 2?
Is this
functions of plus 1 or plus 2?
Your plus 2 topic. Composition is your plus 2 topic. Okay, so I'll stop meeting. My other students are calling me. Okay, plus 1 students. Okay. We will proceed next tomorrow. Tomorrow will be test. Day after tomorrow. Okay? Okay, ji. Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome.
Bye, ma'am.